The previous King of Swords was a giant of a man, both faster and stronger than I. Yet I needed only look up at my legendary fellow to know that I had no choice. I could not die this day. I made a shield under every hand, striking with all my might so that my arms felt they might snap with every impact. Where do I?
A King of Swords is nothing.
Watch if he cannot defend his crown. I began to doubt. Power. It was there. Burning with pain, empty with exhaustion, I stepped inside his faltering swing and I slit the giant's throat. I did not get that. From that day forth, I wore the crown of swords upon my head and the ring of eternal love upon my finger.
The only love you had, Dareso, was for yourself. Cortana. I'm not up to that just yet.
Age 13, carving knife in hand, I killed beasts for the amusement of the filthy. At 15, they thought me worthy to fight a fellow man. A butcher he was, twice as big and twice as stupid as I. I butchered the butcher, and many like him, earned my way, kill by kill. Out of the awful pit, and into the grand arena. I thought I would find wealth and glory in the arena. I was wrong.
Fury and desire, together again. Lovely and lovely. Facets so shiny, replete with the vim of murdered souls. My Malachi did the crafting. Beautiful work. General Aedas did the murdering. Equally beautiful work, in its own juicy way. Num Num's time, my little rapture. Have you ever been to the end of the world before, my king? Asked the blackest monkey. No, I have not, realized the monkey king. There is my reason to go where you go. Be where you be, my king, concluded the blackest monkey in a voice as warm and welcoming as death. Do you know who wrote that? Not a cockroach? Victorio Navalius, the people's poet of Sarn. He was my friend, and I betrayed him. Took his love and burned it before his eyes. Now I am betrayed. My heart burned black by the one man I loved. Malachi. He's found a new heart, you see. A beast's heart to cuddle up to keep him warm and safe at the end of the world. Today, I remind Malachi of his betrayal. Today, it is his turn to burn. Malachi's devices. His creations. He loved them all. Not me. He betrayed me then. Said he loved me. Then said he wanted me to die. He betrays me now. Let me suffer. Let me wither. Am I the one and only mistake that you ever made, Malachi? Yes, that's me. Diala, the Gemling Queen. Malachi's misdemeanor. Make him regret his mistake. Not a cockroach. Tear open the beast's black heart. Rip Malachi from his filthy little nightmare. Cut him. Crush him. Burn him from existence. He deserves no better. And I deserve no worse. No love for me. No love. No love. No love.
So this is what life inside of a nightmare looks like. That would only slow me down. That would only slow me down. would only slow me down. That would only slow me down.
You see what happens when you hunt dreams, Ranger. You've just earned yourself some bigger prey, Huntress. Listen carefully, Ranger, as this is something you will never hear from me again. I was wrong, and you were right. Part of me wishes I'd died at your feet, as was intended. The little girl within me that shies from darkness, from greatness. It was Malachi who reached out to me, who wrapped me in nightmare, made me his slave. He has shown me greatness beyond imagining, so much that I thought my mind would shatter under its weight. And although my mind remains intact, my dreams were not so fortunate. Malachi is in the Beast's black core right now, harnessing all that the Beast is and will be. He will destroy this world and forge it anew in the divine image of Nightmare. Yet as powerful as Malachi has become, he is neither unreachable nor invulnerable. He sacrificed much to become the Beast's prime servant, both in spirit and in flesh, yet three vital organs remain. His heart, lungs, and entrails, keepsakes of humanity lost. They will be our tickets into Malachi's private little show. Venture deeper, deep into Nightmare's abattoir. I'll follow when I'm able. You find me those organs, and I'll get us into the Black Core.